Johnson with some size up front. Robinson at tackle at 305. Inman at guard at 255. The center, 236. 240 on a guard and 195 on that tight end.
Lasker calling signals. Takes the ball and runs McMurray on a sweep, and he got a first down as he crossed the 25. He didn't get a first down, I don't think. He's got close, though. It's very, very close as he got to about the 23, and it's fourth and a yard. Fourth and a yard as he runs a sweep. Big play both sides. 5:40 in the third, and his quarters went by in a hurry. Lassiter going to bring his team out of the huddle. They need a yard. They're on the 23. They got to go to the 22. They're taking a long time to get this playoff. Slot right. Take it, and they run it, and he keeps it, and he cuts it in. I think he got it. We'll have to wait. This is going to be close. John, what do you got on the field? Did Bruce, he get it or not?
Bruce, it's going to be close. It depends on the spot. They spotted it on his knee. I don't think he's going to get it. I think he's going to be about a half a football short, but they're going to measure the thing.
It's very, very close, and you got a better look than us. Here comes the change. Big play right here. 22, the crowd will let you know. They stretch them. They pull them. Give it to the Blue Devils. They have held them. No first down. Lebanon takes over on the 22. He missed it by about 3 inches. Lebanon with a ball, 14-14 with 5:14 to play in the third quarter. DeMont splits to the left, slot left. High set, triplet quarterback. We jump the tackle off five. Sanders got a little in a hurry, or was that Gray? Or was that Dunaway? It was Dunaway who jumped. We'll be penalized five. The crowd got noisy and Dunaway jumped offside. We'll penalize us back to the 17.
Terry, Lebanon has been almost penalty free tonight.
Tommy, that's only their second penalty tonight. Both of them 5 yarders, 2 penalties, 10 yards for Lebanon. Gallatin, 4 penalties for 22.
Slot left, I set. First and 15. We're on a sweep. Lanier trying to get out, got to the 20 and really got hit, didn't get to the 20, got to about the 18, and that's it, he got a yard. Boy, there were a lot of people pursuing. Galton's got an excellent pursuit football team and an excellent line. He got a yard out of it to the 18. We're second and 14.
Bruce, you mentioned pursuit. Galton awfully quick, and they do a lot of chasing to the football. That's why I think at some point that slice trap, some kind of reverse action, misdirection to get Galton going against the flow, maybe we can pop a big play.
Slot left, triplet fakes inside trap. Sellers got to the 20 and got knocked down. First time we've run that play. We tried to run our slot back on the inside trap. And he'd say his knee touched on a 19, only a yard gain. Third down and 13. Third and 13.
John, did it look like he had much of a hole?
Tom, it was really jammed up in there, but he lost his footing, and Jade went down about on the 19th, said his knee touched, but I'm looking for a reverse. I'm kind of like you. They pursue mighty quick.
Third down and 13. We're on our 19, and we're back to pass, and we're setting a screen up, and we throw it out there, but we won't get much. Inman tackled him and brought him down. We fumbled it. I think it's going to be ruled dead. I think we lost a yard on a screen. We were trying to set Lanier up on a screen. And Inman, the linebacker, got in there and knocked him down in the 18 or 17. We lost about 2 out of it. We've got to punt.
Bo Grissom in to punt for the Blue Devils. Daniel Dawson is the up man. In to snap it for the Blue Devils is Jody Atwood. Deep to return is Hall and Chumley.
Well, we're having trouble with our clock again. Here comes the referee over to talk to Mark Medley. Clock operator, really don't know how to run the clock, if you want to really put it up bluntly. And it's 3:58. He runs it pretty well till he gets in a situation when he don't know how to run it.
John, down to you. What's the word?
It's the hard way.
John, what do you got on the clock now?
Well, the umpire came over and told Coach Medley that the clock is jumping from seconds to seconds, like 58 down to 52, then back up to 60. But I hadn't seen that myself. And he said he's going to give it one more try, and then they're going to bring the kid back out on the field.
That umpire hasn't had a lot to drink, has he, John? If he sees that clock jump from 58 to 52, and he's going to, well, they're running it now. I'm not sure what they're doing. Tommy, you?
Bruce, they have put the clock equipment on the side. Raymond Lassiter is working with it. And now Joe Ferguson, the electric clock operator, looks like they're going to be keeping the clock back on the field.
Snap is back. It's a high one. Here they come. Punt is away. It's up in the air. Fair catch call. Far drop and get on it. We should have. I think Gallatin got it. Oh, we had a great opportunity. Yeah, we got it. We got the football. Fumble on the 44, and Lebanon has recovered that football. Joey, I thought he had gotten on it, but he didn't. Somebody for Lebanon got there.
Jody Atwood, yeah. Bruce, the long snapper, got the football. Jody, the first one down the field, as Chumley tried to call the fair catch, the ball went right through the wickets. It comes out, and Lebanon gets great field position. Terry, what about the punt by Bo?
Tommy, 26 yards on the punt, but a very high punt, and that led to the muff. Gallatin's third turnover of the night.
The clock will not work anymore. He's on the field, the clock operator. We cannot tell you how much time there is to play. We know it's in the third quarter. We know it's time. Back to pass, looking for DeMont Stone. Long, long pass, way down the field, incomplete. DeMont Stone was trying to go for the bomb, or trip it was. And we threw that thing way down to the 22, incomplete, second and 10. So it is, John, if you are listening down on the field, try to keep us, how much time is left in the third quarter?
John, I can see our coaches trying to negotiate for a penalty on that play. They felt like DeMond was held, didn't they?
He definitely got shoved or held back a little bit. Looks like the Gallatin defender had a hand on his jersey a little bit, but no flag.
So it's second down and 10. The ball's on the 43 after that fumble by Chambers of Gallatin. Take the ball. We run our fullback up the middle, and Dirksen got across the 45 and got knocked down on the 47 and got about four out of it. Maybe got five out of it. He got five out of it. It's third down and five. Third and five on the 47. We're late somewhere in the third quarter. I assume around 2 minutes. Third down, Lebanon out of the huddle with a slot left. This football game is tied. It was tied at the half. Slot left, eye set, triplet takes it. Sweep, Maneer. Maneer cuts it in, won't get the first down. He'll get to the 49 and got two. We'll have to punt. Ball is on the 49. We've got to go to their 47, I believe. We need about four. Or three and a half. And the clock, I suppose, is running. It's getting somewhere late in the third quarter. We're tied 14-14. Bo Grissom, the punt from his own 35. He steps up a couple of yards. We've got a man standing on the 20. That's Hall. Snap is back. Rushes on, line drive punt. This will hit on the 28. Roll down to the 20, inside of the 20. Roll to the 15, down to the 14. And it comes out good results on a low line drive punt by the sophomore, Bo Grissom. Terry Stafford, how far?
Bruce, from our 49, the ball rolls all the way down to the 14, where we down at 37 yards for Bo Grissom.
So we've got Gallatin backed up on their 14. We need a turnover. We're tied at 14. Clock starts. And, John, if you find out down there how much time there's left, just jump in and tell us every now and then if you find out how much time is left. Slot right. Eye set. Gallatin. Lassiter takes the ball. Runs McMurray. McMurray got hit at the line. He got about a yard, and that's about it. I don't think he got a yard. Give him back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10. No gain. second down and 10. Nobody is coming over to the sideline to inform anybody how much time is left. So they're keeping the... Boy, this messes up your whole game when you have to run it from the field. Second down and 10. Gallatin comes out with a slot left. Hall is a split in over here with a slot back. High set. Lassiter calling signal. Takes the ball. Gives it to Mike Murray. No, he keeps it. He's outside. He got outside, too. Runs it across the 35. Up, check it. Across the 20. Up to the 25 and got knocked down. He's close to a first down. I think he got the first down. That time he drew our end inside. They'll have to measure out. Very, very close again. John, what do you got on the field?
Bruce, he's going to be short about maybe a half a yard. So it's going to be a third down and less than one, looks like. But they're going to measure it anyway.
He got about 9.5. He had to go to the 24. Looks like it's on the 23.5. And like you said, he needed about a half a yard. Doggone, looked like they could have seen that from the sideline, don't it? Everybody else could. They need about almost a yard, really. They keep changing ball, they may need 2 yards. Late somewhere in the third quarter. We do not know how much time is left in the third quarter. We do know it's tied at 14. 14-14. All to the right. Lassiter's quarterback. Calling signals. Takes the ball. McMurray got it, I think. We'll have to wait and see, but I think he got the first down. John, what do you got? First down, Gallatin.
And Zach Dirksen in there at fullback, linebacker, replacing Marlo C. We've got Steve Rose and Zach Dirksen as our two linebackers. Michael Drake in there at free safety for the Blue Devils. A couple of changes there in what we sent out as a starting lineup.
Ball on the 29, first and 10, Gallatin. Tied at 14. And now the referee jumps in and says, I think this is the end of the third quarter. That is. Third quarter's over. We'll be back in 1 minute, Donnie. 1 minute break. Fourth quarter coming up. 10 on the first and 10 on the 29. Gallatin out of the huddle. We start the fourth quarter with no clock. Send a man in motion. Wide to the left, back to pass. Lassiter looking, going long. He's overshot. Everybody incomplete. He was trying to hit Calvin all well covered by Mo Thompson. Threw that football way down on the 35-yard line. Incomplete.
Gallatin sent a man in motion for the first time tonight. They brought the slot man across the formation. That was Brooks trying to roll us out of that zone coverage, but Mo Thompson got back deep into his third and had Hall covered. Incompletion on first down.
Slot right this time, Gallatin. Lebanon and Gallatin tied at 14. Fourth quarter just started. Take the ball. Lassiter sprints to the right, looks, got a man out there. Incomplete. He had a man open up on a 30. He just missed him. He was sending his slot back, number 19, Fisher, and he just overthrew him up on the 30-yard line. Third and 10, big play, and this ball is on the 24.5.
Terry Stafford, what about Lassiter throwing the football?
Tommy Lassiter tonight, 3 of 7, only 40 yards and one interception.
Ball on the 24.5. Third and 10. Big play for both teams. Lassiter may be in a passing situation. He runs a draw. He fakes the draw. We hit him. We sack him. We knocked him down on the 18. Marlo C. Bang.
Marlo came on the blitz. We ran the linebacker back there and knocked the quarterback down for negative yardage. Fourth down and long. Back to punt. For Gallatin is Inman. Deep to return for the Blue Devils is Stone. Mo Thompson is the up man. Inman only 26 yards a kick. That's his average.
We could get great field position here. Snap back to Inman. Inman punts it away. It's a high one.